It would be for the whole thing. I mean, we would still, I mean, at this point, we still have jurisdiction over the 280, but obviously you would have a real key part of us getting to that, so.
And those parameters would be defined as we written down the road?
Yes.
Now, we give you a decision at the December meeting, is that early enough?
Yeah, I think it's fine. I don't wanna rush you whenever you guys, you know, obviously you have a lot on your plate, so I just wanted to make sure that kinda got you up to speed a little bit. And then as soon as I get this planning document finalized, which we'll be meeting again probably next month, definitely we'll make sure that you get a copy of that so you can peruse it and strike things.
Is anybody here opposed to teaming up with them?
Not in principle, it stands right now. I'm not
prepared to make a decision tonight, I can get the ball rolling, but I don't want to.
Well, the question would be asked to you, Karen, is it getting answered, might mean anything happens?
It's not gonna make or break it, you can wait till next month if you want, and that way we can get something.
So then I guess it's not a way to allow, make sure it's a fair decision.
Yep. Alright, well, thank you. Any other questions?
Yeah, table it till the December meeting.
Thank you for your time, I appreciate it.
Thank you. Resume Robert's rules.
Leave that there.
NHS volunteering, I know it's been, from my observation before joining again, it's been Mary Beth's great child. I did not see any report from her regarding NHS.
I don't think there's a whole lot to report on it, other than the fact that she told me that, you know, she has the information out to the Whitehall Public Schools and to the best of my knowledge, none of the NHS kids have stepped forward yet, but Mary Beth would have more information on that.
The list is on the website as well. I think she also wanted to know if there was anything else that you would like to add to the list, if there's anything you could think of to add to it. She wants just a little bit of help with that, if there's anything you can think of that could be added to it.
I think removing that, spike things there by the tennis courts, that, you know, those need to be, but we talked to her about that, so she might have already added it.
We can, hopefully she'll be able to attend the December meeting and be able to give us an update on what the volunteers have or have not accomplished at this point. And the rest of us can take a look at some other things that having volunteers help would be great. Update on pavilion door replacement?
Yeah, that's my baby. I've met with two contractors about it, and I'm waiting on estimates from both of them. I don't feel comfortable using the Lowe's recommended general contractors. Sometimes their information is outdated, sometimes their licenses aren't up to date, their insurances aren't current, so I met with two other ones. One was for the rubber lumber, and the other one was something like that. And I hope to have an answer, certainly before, I'd say by the end of next, this is the second. So next weekend will be the 13th, so by Friday the 13th I should have the information back to me before. I'd like to get it done before I'm here for later.
And these contractors that you're gonna meet with, is that still installing double doors, or
yes,
are you gonna ask for other?
Well, there's two we already have arranged with Lowe's. The door we already have arranged with Lowe's, so it's just a matter of getting the install. So that's why I'm working on the install piece, because I don't feel comfortable with the quality of contract that Lowe's.
And because I have not seen those quotes, because what's Lowe's value for the contract, their contract to come out? Is that it?
I think that was included in the install price was $773 or $770.
And that included the doors, the lock sets, and the installation.
From the installation, the lock sets are going to be separate purchase from them, correct?
Okay. Okay. All right, we'll keep us posted.
Yes.
So is that something we need to table to December, or is that something we need to go ahead with?
No, we.
I did. What I understand from the last meeting is that it's been approved.
Yeah, the budget's there for it, the money's there for it, it's just
so whenever you
nailing down the pieces,
right? Price, and
yes.
Then you go ahead and do
yeah.
It.
Perfect. Park inspections?
I don't know who had it for this month, but
I did, and I had it last, and I gave mine back. I don't know who had it after me.
I know I've seen a few things, and that's those little protrusions up there by the
like to put 4x4 posts up on the outside of them to firm those up. So I think that'd be a good way to go. I did count it out, we need 58 4x4s and 29 bags of cement, which comes out to, I figured about $650. So that's a project that we'd have to approve through R&M, repair and maintenance. But I think probably the sooner the better that would that be done. So I'd like to make a motion that we get that approved to have 4x4 posts put in. And Jerry said he'll do it. He might need our assistance in helping him do it because it's kind of an involved project.
Could we count on some of the NHS volunteering to assist with that?
Well, I'll help for sure. Hopefully we can get some NHS kids too. I know Mark will.
Oh, I get volunteer calls to make this project.
But anyway, I'd like to make a motion that we do that and fund it through R&M.
And how much R&M funds are available in the budget?
The total was $2,500 at the beginning of the year. At this point, we've used
$1,000 of it basically with Patrick Bowman.
That was under capital expenditures.
Okay.
That was under the $8,000 for capital expenditures for tree trimming and Patrick's project.
Okay.
So we did a lot, $300 out of that for the erosion project, the Eagle Spout project, and $500 out of that for tree guards. So if we did indeed spend that, that would take that up to about more or less than $1,000, because there's still $1,500 left.
Well, I agree that both sets of stairs have been neglected for a number of years, and that they do need to be shored up a bit, as well as I think there's item number 6, which we might as well handle that while we're looking at this as well.
That's done? Jerry finished it up today.
I mean, $650 of materials for 4x4s and a little bit of concrete to shore up those stairs, I think is money well spent.
Agreed.
Jerry did say one thing about if we do move to the number 6 there too. He did make the step, but there's still, even with making the step, there's still a little bit of a drop off because there's just a natural erosion going on there. And he recommended making another 4x4 landing just so that every time somebody lands on there, they're not increasing the erosion. And I placed that out, and that would be about $20. So I'd include that.
It's a 4x4 landing platform for $28.
Yeah, it's just, you know, 2x4s and then, you know, your 2x6s over the top of it.
You know, $28? Mm-hmm. We'll take two of them.
Yeah, and $28 will take two of them.
Well, I mean, I priced it just going online, you know, through Lowe's. That's what the lumbering costs. So.
Sure.
I don't object to the idea of shoring up those shaky steps, but this kind of ad hoc approach to expenditures for maintenance strikes me as not an optimal way to proceed, especially when we may be faced with unknown costs associated with the disc golf course. And I'd rather see a comprehensive plan for the use of the funds available rather than saying, oh, this sounds like a good idea, let's spend $600.
Well, I agree. I think that some of these maintenance issues will be addressed in future budgets, and we'll be able to plan for them more accordingly.
Why not plan now? We know how much money we've got.
Well, this is a safety issue at this point, and
well, it's not the only one.
No,
time in the morning to a specific time in the evening, I think is what they.
My problem we run into is that, you know, sunrise and sunset hours vary.